Before beginning my presentation, I would like to present myself. I'm Professor Khalid Rahmani from the Department of Physics, Polydisciplinary Faculty in Sultan Moulay Slimane University in Imlef, Morocco. First of all, I would like to thank very warmly Professor Mahmoud Khanfouch for inviting me to participate in the second edition of this prestigious scientific event, Nano 18. I congratulated him for having the idea to organize this online conference, and thus I wish him a success. So, the title of my presentation is Hydrostatic Pressure and magnetic field effect on the diamagnetic susceptibility and polarizability for a shallow magneto-donor in GaAs quantum box.
My presentation will organize it as follows. As first, I will present the theoretical approach used in this work, and then I will present my results and discussion. Introduction. In this last decade, the advances in nanofabrication technology have made it possible to manufacture low-dimensional semiconductor materials such as quantum well, where the carriers of charge are confined in one direction and consequently are free to move at two directions. The charge density is continuous and it has the form of a step of staircase. Quantum well where the carrier of charge are confined in two directions and consequently are free to move at one direction. Quantum dot, where the carrier of charge are confined in three directions. The density of charge is discontinuous while the energy levels are confined. The quantum dots are found in several geometric shapes, cubic, spherical, and cylindrical. A new structure called inhomogeneous quantum dot or core shell has been developed. It is on several geometric shapes. In this nanostructure, the optical and electronic properties depend strongly of the size of the heterostructure, the position of the impurity, and the external excitation applied, such as electric field, magnetic field, temperature, hydrostructure pressure. In this work, we will study the simultaneous effects of the hydrostatic pressure and the magnetic field on the diamagnetic susceptibility and the polarizability of a shallow magneto-donor located at the center in the GaAs quantum dot. Our calculations are made using the variational method within the effective mass approximation. Now I'm going to present the theoretical model adopted. We consider a hydrogenic impurity located at the center of the quantum box of GaAs surrounded by GaAlAs in the presence of hydrostatic pressure and magnetic field applied along the Z direction. The confinement potential is assumed as a model of an infinite deep well. The gallium arsenide is a 3-5 direct bandgap semiconductor with a zinc blank crystal structure. Its bandgap is 1.42. The gallium aluminium arsenide is a semiconductor material with very nearly the same lattice constant as the GaAs, but a larger band gap. The band gap vary between 1.42 and 2.16. When X is less than 0.4, the band gap is direct. The Hamiltonian of a donor impurity is given by the expression number 1, with gamma characterizing the magnetic field strength, with omega c is the effective cyclotron frequency, f is the dimensionless parameter that characterizes the intensity of the electric field, with r and a are respectively the effective Rydberg and Bohr radius. They depend on the effective mass, the static dielectric constant of GaAs, and the potential barrier height, and they present respectively a unit of energy and length. The dielectric constant and the conduction effective mass for the electron of the quantum box vary with the hydrostatic pressure respectively according to the relation number 2 and number 3. The potential barrier depends on the pressure and the concentration of the aluminium according to the expression number 4. The table 1 presents the variation of effective mass, dielectric constant, electric bar radius, effective Rydberg, and the potential barrier with hydrostatic pressure for the well material and the barrier material for two concentration of aluminium x equal 0.1 and 0.13. To resolve the Schrödinger equation, we use the Haas variational method and we estimate the following wave function psi, where beta is variational parameter which takes into account the presence of the electric field and psi zero is the wave function in the absence of electric field. The energy is obtained by the minimization with respect to the variational parameters E, B, and beta is given by the expression number 6, and the diamagnetic susceptibility of an impurity confined in a quantum box in atomic unit given by the expression number 7. The polarizability of a shallow magneto-donor is given by the expression number 9, with P is the dipole moment defined by the difference of the average value of R in the presence and the absence of the electric field. Now we present our results and discussion. In figure 2, we represent the variation of the barrier height depending on the hydrostatic pressure. We note that for different value of the aluminium concentration, the height of the barrier depends on the applied hydrostatic pressure. The height of the barrier decreases with increasing hydrostatic pressure. Figure 3 shows the variation of the diamagnetic susceptibility of a hydrogenic impurity as function of the length of the box for different value of the hydrostatic pressure. We can observe that the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility increases with increasing the width of the box. The effect of the hydrostatic pressure is more important for large quantum box and neglected for small quantum box. For large quantum box, when the hydrostatic pressure increases, the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility decreases. This is because that the wave function is more localized, and thus the value of the average value of R squared is diminished with increasing the pressure, which leads to modify the value of the diamagnetic susceptibility. We remark in table 1 that the expression of the effective mass and dielectric constant increases, and consequently the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility decreases with increasing the hydrostatic pressure. Our results are in good agreement with the reference. Figure 4 presents the variation of the diamagnetic susceptibility as a function of the magnetic field for different widths of the quantum box in the absence of the hydrostatic pressure. We can observe that the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility increases as the width of the box increases. For small quantum box, L equal 1 and L equal 1.25, the magnetic field effect is neglected and become more pronounced for large quantum box L equal 2 and L equal 3. When the magnetic field increases, the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility decreases. It's due to the stronger confinement effect of the magnetic field and the spatial confinement. We can say that in the low dimensional nanostructure, when the size of the structure is large, the induced confinement by the effect of the magnetic field becomes dominant, which are important in device application based on the low dimensional nanostructure. Our results are in good agreement with the reference. Figure 5 shows the variation of the diamagnetic susceptibility as a function of the length of the quantum box for different value of the hydrostatic pressure and endermagnetic field applied simultaneously, gamma equal 2. It seems that the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility decreases as the length of the quantum box increases as expected. And it's noticed that the variation of the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility is not pronounced for a smaller quantum box due to the domination of geometrical confinement. For larger quantum box, it's clear that the geometric confinement induced by a magnetic field is dominant in which the wave function is more concentrated around the amperity. The results show that for large quantum box, the effect of both external perturbation seems to take part equally, which is induced to a strong confinement and a more impressive decrease of the absolute value of the diamagnetic susceptibility. Now we have calculated the polarizability of a magneto-donor placed in the center of the quantum box, and we have evaluated the influence of the hydrostatic pressure and the magnetic field and the size of the quantum box. In figure 6, we present the polarizability of a donor amperity as a function of the width of the cubic box for different value of the hydrostatic pressure. It can be seen that the polarizability increases with the increase of the size of the cubic quantum dot. It's due to the compression of the wave function. In addition, the polarizability becomes more important when we increase the hydrostatic pressure. The hydrostatic pressure is negligible for the small quantum dot, L inferior to 1.5, because the geometric confinement effect is predominant and become more significant for large quantum dot L superior to 2. In the figure 7, we present the variation of the polarizability as a function as the strong magnetic field, the square gamma, for three different values of the size of the box. We notice that the magnetic field reduces the polarizability. Its effect is more important for large value of the quantum box, L equal 4 and 5, which confine the electron in the box by increasing its bending energy. For small quantum dot, the polarizability is almost independent of the magnetic field. Our results are in good agreement with the literature. In figure 8, we presented the polarizability as a function of the hydrostatic pressure in the absence and in the presence of the strong magnetic field, gamma equal 3. This figure shows a certain competition between the geometric confinement, the magnetic field, and the hydrostatic pressure. We see that the polarizability is independent for small quantum box and becomes more sensitive for large quantum dot, especially under the simultaneous effects of the hydrostatic pressure and the magnetic field, reflecting the additional confinement due to the application of the pressure and the magnetic field. We can analyze this behavior that two effects reduce the wave function and become more compressed in the box and increasing the bending energy that affects the polarizability and reduce it. Our results are in good agreement with the literature. Conclusion. In this work, we have studied the effect of the hydrostatic pressure and the magnetic field on the polarizability and the diamagnetic susceptibility of an amperity confined to move in a quantum box. We have solved analytically the Schrödinger equation using the variational method of Haas. Our results show that when the hydrostatic pressure or the magnetic field increase, the diamagnetic susceptibility decreases and the polarizability increases and become more sensitive for larger quantum box. For small quantum box, the diamagnetic susceptibility and the polarizability remain independent for hydrostatic pressure and the magnetic field. I believe that our results will be useful in nanofabrication. Thank you for attention. Merci pour votre attention. شكرا على انتباهكم.